Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This is Sergio Briones. Today, July 8th, 2021. If you are new to the channel, this channel is about personal finance and how I run my grocery store and my real estate portfolio. Feel free to subscribe if you're on the path to becoming a millionaire. I will teach you the ropes and guide you until you also become financially independent. First of all, for those of you thinking after seeing my last video announcing I was a millionaire, I want to clarify that I do not have $1 million sitting in my bank account or buried under my foxtail palm tree. I am a millionaire because I have accumulated assets that are worth around $2.2 million. If I would sell all my assets, which include my rental portfolio and my convenience store, and pay off all the debts, I would walk away with a little more than $1 million. So having cleared the air, now to the video. I want to explain the difference between being broke and being poor. Many friends laugh when they hear me say I do not have money to take a $500 weekend vacation. They know I have multiple streams of income and don't understand how I can say I do not have $500 to spend on the beach. They will sometimes call us names. Greedy, stingy, old-fashioned, party pooper, etc. Sometimes even my wife questions how other people who we know that make less than we do get to travel all over the world without breaking a sweat. I always remind her that they may have other priorities, or that they, like many, might be living it up using a credit card. We, on the other hand, have made the decision to continue living under our means, even till this day, always delaying the gratification. The cash flow from our properties gets reinvested into more properties. And we even save 50% of our payroll from our convenience store and dump it into more real estates. The snowball has grown over time. And in 6 years, when I turn 40, we are programmed to pay everything off, including the mortgages, and will be worth around $2 million. We will have a monthly cash flow of about $30,000. Not chump change anymore, if you ask me. And to clarify, we did not win the lottery or inherit any properties. Everything has been meticulously planned for. God has been our witness from day one. And you will be here to watch the next part of our journey. I am always broke, but never poor. I stopped being poor years ago. For me, being poor is a mindset of scarcity. I have a wealthy mindset of abundance. I just always decide to invest all of my profits for even more income-producing assets. And in the meantime, I appear broke. But at least for me, being broke is optional, because I am forcing myself to not have any money left to spend frivolously. Unfortunately, being poor sometimes is not so optional. Poor people first need to change their mindset and start thinking like the wealthy people do, even if they don't have any money and are barely scraping by. We need to understand that the world has trillions of dollars floating around. Whoever stands out and solves a problem gets compensated. The amount you get is up to you. We know people are always hungry, including myself. You can contribute to someone else's dream by working at McDonald's and get compensated very little, or you can decide to open your own restaurant and get a much bigger piece of the food industry. Will it be tough? Of course it will be tough competing with the giants. That's why many people concentrate on niche markets where competition is limited. We just need to remember that failure is part of the process. But after a few or many failures, success will always come. So keep hustling. That's the end of the video. If you found value in my words, don't forget to subscribe and smash the like button. We are up to 213 subscribers. I thank God for each and every one of you. God bless.